les interviews du Doc. C'est maintenant sur Vinny Time.
Voilà, et bah écoutez, on va aller dans la découverte aujourd'hui, puisque alors là, pour le coup, on va aller découvrir un nouveau groupe qui s'appelle The CEO. Voilà, alors ça vous dit pas grand-chose, mais en tout cas, c'est un premier album qui va sortir le 25 juin via le label Rat Pack Records. Voilà, le 25 juin, donc vous pourrez écouter la totalité de cet album The CEO Redemption. Et avec moi, en direct, nous avons le chanteur Mac qui va nous parler de cet album et qui va parler aussi de son histoire. Vous allez voir, Mac Mullins, il a une histoire. En tout cas, on est très content de l'avoir avec nous. Mac, thank you so much for accepting my invitation. It's a great, great, great pleasure to speak with you regarding this first release from the CEO Redemption.
Bonjour, and thank you so much for having us. We're very excited to be here and... glad to be talking to you, so thank you.
So Mac, maybe 2 weeks before this first release come back for all the listeners all over the world, so what is your feeling on this Monday?
Yeah, I'm telling you, we're super excited. Obviously you said it was the debut record for us, so this is relatively new for us, so everything is pretty much done for the first time, so it's a huge learning curve for us. We're very excited about the album coming out. The single has been received really well so far. We're excited about the first few singles that have come out, and we look forward to getting the entire record out and getting some feedback. Letting us know what you like and what you don't like and why, and those types of things. So very exciting times for us.
Eh ben voilà, donc comme le dit Mac, ben ils sont très très contents, hein. On est lundi, on enregistre l'interview, bien sûr, vous l'avez compris, donc ils sont très excités. Donc l'album sort le 25 juin, c'est une première, c'est un premier disque, hein. Alors pour le coup, ils ont besoin de savoir si c'est bien, si c'est pas bien, qu'est-ce qui est pas bon. Et puis on parlera donc de ce groupe avec Mac, hein, puisqu'on va quand même juste vous dire qui compose The CEO. Donc il y a Mac Mullins qui est au chant, qui est le chanteur qui est avec nous, Vince Hornsby de Seven Dust à la basse, Chas Brown et Bo Anderson à la guitare et Joseph Herman à la batterie. Voilà, c'est le premier album Redemption, The CEO. Voilà, je pense qu'on va vous faire découvrir déjà les deux titres. Il y a Redemption et Beyond These Eyes qui sont sortis. Beyond These Eyes vient juste de sortir en vidéo. Je pense que vous pouvez aller le regarder. Mac, I see a lot of fantastic review and comments regarding these two first songs that you share with us. Redemption and since last week, Beyond These Eyes. So are you very happy and very confident now when you see all these fantastic comments and something like that on your YouTube channel?
I am, and again, it's one of those things that where when you're in the studio or you're writing the record and you're putting together, those songs that mean something to you that obviously, fit what it is that we're doing, and obviously we're very excited about it. These are like our children, so we love them, but then you put it out to the world and you hope that it means something to them, that it in some way hits home with them in some way, or maybe it's just a tune that obviously sits well with them. So it's a super exciting time for us, and this is very, very good place to be right now.
Bah voilà, comme le dit Mac, hein, donc il y a deux titres qui sont sortis déjà, hein, vous pouvez découvrir. Donc il y a Beyond These Eyes qui est sorti il y a pas très longtemps, et puis le morceau Redemption, hein, qui amène bien sûr le titre de l'album. Alors comme il dit Mac, c'est vraiment une très très bonne partie, parce que c'est le bon moment pour arriver, c'est le bon moment pour faire découvrir la musique, et puis ils sont super contents de tous les commentaires. Allez regarder un petit peu sur la page YouTube, allez regarder sur leur page Facebook, vous allez voir, il y a de très très bons commentaires, et puis le son il est vraiment très très fort, et je pense que c'est une grande partie de cet album est vraiment un album très très lourd. Mac, this release with the first songs that you share with us, Redemption, you are totally on the approach of loud sounds, beautiful riff guitar, fantastic vocal songs. Do you think this is what you expected when you start Redemption?
I think so, yes, because the unique makeup of the band. I mean, we've got a couple of guys in the band that are in their early 20s. Our drummer's in his 30s, and of course, Vinny and I are in our 50s. So you can imagine the influences that each one of us have. Obviously, Vinny and I come from an older school rock, classic rock, from Zeppelin to Van Halen to Kiss and that type of thing, to the guys, the younger guys in the band that are, you know, more in tune with probably some of the more modern, you know, tunings and drum styles and that kind of thing. So when you blend this, you know, dichotomy of influences together, you know, you're going to get a sound, or you should get a sound that's very similar to what we produced out of it. And of course, you know, it helps to have someone like Michael Elvis Basquette as your producer, who's, you know, makes it all work. So we were very lucky and pleased to have him as our producer. So we couldn't be more thrilled with the outcome.
Bah, comme il le dit, voilà, donc le premier titre hein, qui était sorti, c'est Redemption. Franchement, on l'écoutera, vous allez voir, c'est vraiment une chanson très très bonne, très très lourde, avec beaucoup de guitare, c'est très très lourd, c'est vraiment un super morceau. Et comme le dit Mac, bah, en fait, compte, ce qu'il voulait, c'était exactement ce son. C'est des gens qui viennent de différents... particularité, puisqu'ils aimaient bien écouter du classic rock, Led Zeppelin, Van Halen, hein, voilà, on a dit. Et puis avec ça, ils ont mixé tout ça. Et donc l'album, il est produit par Michael Basquette, qui a fait le Mammoth qui vient de sortir, Alter Bridge, bien sûr Seven Dust, le Miles Kennedy, Tremonti. Bon voilà, quand vous comprenez qui est Michael Basquette qui a fait qui a produit cet album, vous vous doutez bien que le son, c'est un très très gros son. Mac, another remark regarding the first songs, because I have a chance to listen all your albums since several days now, and again, thank you so much, because it is really a good one, and when I listen the first song, Twin Flames, I listen your vocal, it's very particular on these songs. I like the beginning of your of this. I would like to say the opening songs, Twin Flames. So it's very particular for me, because when I put the CD on the record, I said, "Wow, what a beautiful song with a lot of guitars, and your voice is fantastic on Twin Flames." So are you happy with your songs? With your vocals on each song during this Redemption first records.
Yeah, and thank you for pointing that out. You know, it's typical that, you know, at least for me, when I want to put on an album, you know, that first track has really got to hit me hard, you know. So, you know, when we were looking at the lineup of what songs should go where, you know, obviously Twin Flames stuck out. It's a, you know, it's a real banger right to start. Kind of gives you, you know, a glimpse of what to expect in the album. So we're very... very, very pleased with that. And then of course, you know, being in the studio again with Michael Basquette and working with him, he just knew how to get the best out of each one of us. I'm very pleased that you know, how well that each one of the tracks came out, you know, and how different they all feel, but then again work, you know, real well together. So it feels like a complete album to me. It's sonically, I, you know, right where it needs to be. Super excited about that, and you know, I couldn't be more happy with how it turned out. So thank you for saying that. Much appreciated.
Voilà, bah comme le dit Mac, hein, quand vous allez écouter le titre Twin Flame, vous allez voir, sa voix elle est fantastique, et tout l'album est vraiment très très bien produit, une nouvelle fois par Michael Basquette. Et puis d'écouter ces titres, voilà, qui s'enchaînent, qui sont vraiment très actuels, très modernes, très très forts. Ben vous allez voir que c'est vraiment peut-être un des meilleurs albums de l'année. Mac, I said, maybe when your listener discovers this Redemption, he said, maybe we have one of the most important records of 2021.
Oh, wow, that's huge. Thank you.
It's very energetic. When I start with the second, because we share the second songs, Behind These Eyes, again, this is very particular, because the beginning of the song is very calm, I would like to say, in French, calm. And after that, we have this beautiful guitar with a comeback with a lot of energy. This is very actual, this is very fresh. I would like to know how you build all your songs and all your different approach when you start very calm, and after that you have a lot of energy, like a hurricane with coming on the faces.
Yeah, I mean, typically that's what, you know, a lot of times you want to, you draw them in with the first 30 seconds, get them listening, and then, you know, like a strong punch to the face. So it, I'm very excited about that one. That's why we released it twice as the second single off the album, because we kind of bouncing back and forth of which to, you know, which to put out first. And I think Redemption is just more of a straight ahead rocker, as where, you know, Behind His Eyes has got those little nuances, if you would. It takes a little bit to get to the meat and potatoes of it, but we're very, very proud of it. And hopefully, the audience, whether it, you know, has an opportunity to, you know, listen to those and can appreciate some of the nuances that we put into it.
Et ben voilà, alors quand vous allez découvrir le titre, Behind This Eyes, vous allez voir le titre, il commence tout doucement, et puis d'un seul coup, comme je le disais, c'est très calme au début, le morceau est très planant, puis d'un seul coup on se prend en pleine poire, les guitares qui arrivent, c'est vraiment un son très très lourd, c'est comme un hurricane, j'ai plus le mot en français, mais en tout cas, voilà, ça vous prend en pleine poire, et puis vous écoutez l'album et vous dites, waouh, quel album! Quel titre, et franchement tout l'album est comme ça, et c'est incroyable. Mac, maybe one remarks regarding the story behind the CEO, because you have a friend with Vince Hornsby, who is play bass on Seven Dust, and you have a parallel story with Vince, because you are since many times an home child, so you help a lot of people, and between this story you create the CEO. It's a fantastic story.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it. You know, it's one of those things where, you know, a couple years ago when we were first putting this together, it was just kind of put together as a demo, if you would, and we put together a few songs, and we were able to basically have an album release party of the first one. Just from friends and family and that kind of thing. And Vince was there, and he got a chance to see us play and listen to the songs. And he really fell in love with the band and the guys in the band. And he sent us down. He was the one that sent us down to Michael Besquet and said, hey, let's work with these guys for a little bit and see what we can get out of them. So we went down and recorded four songs. And by the time we get done with the fourth song, you know, Michael was calling Vinny up saying, hey, not only do I like this band and I think they're going to write a great record, but you're going to come down and you're going to be the bass player in this band. And that's really how it started. And we have had nothing but a great time, laughs. He's been a phenomenal resource for us and just a super cool guy. So we're very lucky to have, Vinny with us, you know, really kind of to show us the path, if you would. So he's doing a phenomenal job, and we're excited to have him.
Et ben voilà, comme le dit Mac. Alors il y a une histoire derrière The CEO, hein, les amis, parce qu'en fait Mac Mullin et Vince Hornsby, le bassiste de Seven Dust, ben, ils sont rencontrés parce qu'à travers leur histoire commune, ils ont longtemps fait le tour des foyers d'accueil. Ils ont fait le tour de foyers d'accueil et puis ils se sont rencontrés comme ça. Et donc Mac et Vince, ben, ils ont eu la chance de pouvoir se rencontrer, d'écouter. Ils ont d'abord été appelés le producteur, Monsieur Basket, et puis ils ont dit ben voilà, on va enregistrer quelques titres, on va voir ce que ça donne. Et puis comme il le dit Mac, bah c'est vraiment une belle surprise d'avoir pu travailler avec Vince, parce que c'est un super mec et ils sont très très contents d'avoir fait cet album. Et moi en tout cas je vous conseille donc cet album The CEO Redemption. Il sort le 25 juin via Ratpad. C'est un vrai bon album. Mac, do you think after that you have the possibility to tour with Seven Dust and maybe have the CEO at the guest of Seven Dust and Vince play two gigs?
Well, you know, I certainly hope so. We've certainly talked to those guys about it, and you know, if there's an opportunity to do so, you know, I seem to think that will definitely happen. And you know, Vinny has told me that he's an old dog, but he can play for a while. So we're all excited and seem to think that that is going to happen sooner rather than later. So yes.
Et ben voilà. Donc est-ce que on pourrait avoir Seven Dust avec The CEO en première partie et puis Vince qui jouerait sur les deux groupes? Ben, en tout cas, Mac qui dit ouais ça serait super, et puis peut-être que ça viendra. En tout cas, il serait capable de le faire, et ben nous on se ferait un grand plaisir de les voir ensemble, parce que c'est vraiment très très bien. Mac, few words regarding the artwork. It's a beautiful one. I don't know clearly what we share with this artwork, but it's a wonderful one. With create this artwork, and what is the idea or the feeling behind this artwork?
Well, you know, it's one of those things where the record label has, you know, a couple of artists on staff with them. And, you know, they were like, hey, we want to send this to an artist in, I want to say Brazil, name is Jean Michael. Mm-hmm. And just kind of, you know, kind of tell them who we are, what we're about, let him listen to the music a little bit and have him come up with some different concepts. Well, he threw two of them at us, and both of them were phenomenal and we thought were really cool and kind of lent to, you know, obviously the CEO concept and, you know, some of the lyrics in the song. And, you know, we thought it was kind of, you know, honored backwards to some of the classic rock albums and the really cool artwork with it. So it kind of all worked really well together. And Jean-Michel's super talented. So, you know, we thought it worked really, really well. And, you know, we're glad to have him work on our behalf.
Et ben voilà, donc ben, l'idée c'était, ben, comme le disait, ils n'avaient pas d'idée précise sur le cover, sur l'artwork, et puis le label a plusieurs artistes, notamment des Brésiliens, et puis il y a quelqu'un qui a proposé plusieurs covers, et puis voilà, c'est celle qui a été retenue. Alors c'est un gars avec c'est du bleu, il y a un petit peu du futuriste, c'est très classique, mais en tout cas c'est une très très belle pochette. En tout cas, je vous rappelle donc The Redemption est le nom de l'album, le groupe s'appelle The CEO et l'album sort le 25 juin, c'est sur Rat Pat Records. Voilà, il y a vraiment du très très lourd. Quoi vous dire en plus, ben voilà, je vais vous donner la liste des titres. Donc il y a Twin Flames, Beyond This Day, Redemption, Black Earth, Dirty Tragic, The Storm, Alive, Beginning and the End, Bourbon Strike, pas mal celui-là, Walk of Earth, Casting Shadows, Alone and Dead. C'est les titres de l'album. Nous sommes avec Mac Mullin, le chanteur, voilà, le chanteur de The CEO. Mac, what is the plan just after the release? And the do you have a chance to have some gigs in the US to play some songs? Or maybe we have to wait a better situation?
Well, right now, we just have to wait for Seven Dots and Vince to do their run. So once they're done with their, because, you know, their record came out quite a bit before ours did. So they've been sitting on the sidelines for a while. So they've got their tour booked. And when they're done, then it'll be our turn. So, you know, we're thinking fall or early winter, we'll play some shows here in the States and see where it goes from there. So that's kind of our plan right now.
Voilà, bah, le plan, vous l'avez compris, hein, donc il y a d'abord Seven Dust en premier, et donc bah, ils vont attendre d'avoir les dates et de que toutes les dates soient bookées, que la tournée se termine, et puis juste après, donc peut-être pour la fin de l'année, il y aura des concerts aux États-Unis de The CEO, avec le groupe au complet, hein, donc je le rappelle, il y a donc Mac Mullin au chant, Vince Hornsby, le bassiste de Seven Dust, Chas Brown et Bo Anderson à la guitare, et Joseph Herman à la batterie. Voilà, c'est un début d'album, ça s'appelle Redemption, c'est vraiment un super, 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 super album. Et en tout cas, bah, on aura plaisir à aller voir, j'espère, en Europe. Maybe one word regarding the songs we call Alive. Are you alive, Mac, with these records?
We are absolutely alive. So we are present and alive, and we hope that your listeners are too.
Yeah, for sure. Bah voilà, donc il y a un titre aussi qui s'appelle Alive. Alors je posais la question à Mac, est-ce qu'il est totalement alive avec ce Redemption? Et ben oui, il a rigolé et puis il dit oui, bah, bien sûr, on est complètement vivant et on aura plaisir. En tout cas, moi j'aurai plaisir à l'écouter. J'espère que vous l'écouterez, donc ce Redemption quand il sortira, c'est un super album. Again, Mac, thank you so much for your times. I know you are in US, I'm in France, so this is what we have with connectivity. I would like to say it's a great, great, great pleasure to speak with you. Before we ending this interview, Mac, do you have a message for the French listener?
I'd like to tell everybody in France and your listeners, merci beaucoup. We really appreciate you guys listening to it. You can reach us through Facebook and Instagram, and we'd love to hear from you. And if, you know, let us know what you think. So, you know, we love you, and we can't wait to get over there and see you.
Et ben voilà, comme le dit Mac, il vous remercie. Allez sur les pages Facebook, Instagram, allez regarder ce qui se passe pour The CEO, allez mettre un petit commentaire, ça leur fera plaisir. Et puis surtout, allez écouter le disque, hein, parce que j'espère qu'on les verra. Mac, just before we stop this interview, can you please introduce the songs just after the interview with called Redemption?
Okay, tell me again what you'd like me to say.
Can you please introduce the song Redemption for the listener?
Yeah, absolutely. Hi, this is Mac Mullins from the CEO, and you're listening to Redemption.
Ouais! Mac, thank you so much.
Les interviews du Doc, c'est maintenant sur Vinyl Time.